My name is Nigel Redman. I am Vice President of Engineering for Markertek. And we're very excited about this product that we're going to be demonstrating to you today. In the world of soundproofing and acoustical engineering and acoustic requirements, there are always new products that come out every day that we're very interested in. This is one of the products that caught our eye that I think is a unique product because it solves an age-old problem of sound isolation. The ability to dampen sound from one point to another has always been a problem for sound engineers. And when you're building acoustical environments like TV studios, sound recording booths, sound studios, you really want to be able to isolate sound between point A and point B because sound transitions through material, through contact. And conventional older methods of doing this was to create what's called a floating wall, which basically you put wall one is separated from wall two by space. You use a rubber or what's called a sleeper or a cleat to isolate the walls, and therefore you were able to use air as a medium to separate sound from passing from point A to point B. Today there are some radical new ways to do this, and one of the products that we're going to be featuring today is called Green Glue. And that product is exactly designed to do that, which is to give you isolation and dampening without having to build separate walls in the conventional form of using sleepers or floaters. And that's what we're going to demo today. We have on the left over here two surfaces that are made of ceramic tile, and they're basically glued together with conventional adhesive. And the reason we use a hard ceramic tile is just to show an idea of a hard surface and how it easily conducts sound from point A to point B. And on the right side, we have the same exact tile. At this time, it is bonded using the sound dampening compound of green glue. And here, if you listen carefully, you will hear exactly what it sounds like using conventional adhesive. Now you could clearly see from that demonstration that sound simply moves from point A to point B because surface number one and surface number two are in resonance together, and therefore the adhesive in the middle is doing absolutely nothing to eliminate the sound. Now we're going to go to the right side, in which case green glue has now been applied. And you listen carefully, we'll do the same thing. That clearly demonstrates the fact that on one side you have adhesive and on one side you have green glue, and you can see that the sound resonant factor has been severely dampened by using the green glue as a dampening compound, which also forms an adhesive bond between the two. It's actually creating a small microscopic ear gap that is allowing the sound not to pass from point A to point B. We want to show you what it looks like in reality. This is a little sample board I put together, and it simply has on the top a dollop of this compound. You can see when I put my fingers in it, it is not wet, but yet it is not solid. It stays in this gummy type of format. And now I can move down a piece of wood I installed above it, and you can see it moves and shifts. Did this a month ago. So 30 days later, you can see that the product still remains in this kind of gooey compound, and that the layer of woods that are put together still can shift, of course. So you do get an adhesive characteristic as well as a continual floating, almost like a butyl seal type of characteristic as well, which is what you need to create that gap and allow the dampening effect to occur.